Macron's government linked its survival to the adoption of the reform. Oppositional parties from the left and the far right voted for the motion of censure, but the Conservative Party did not support them by enough votes, so the motion of censure finally failed by missing 9 votes only. The result is that Macron's government remains in place and the reform of the pension system is automatically adopted. This failure marks the end of institutional recourse against this widely unpopular reform rejected by 80% of the French population. Over the past 3 months, workers' union demonstrations have been massive, with 3.5 million of people in the streets across France at its peak. Strikes have also been massive for the last 20 days with mobilization in all sectors of French societies. 4 days of general strike, blocked motorway, massive mobilization notably by dustmen in refineries, airport, ports, but also within universities, with about 50 of them already blocked and occupied all over France. Overall, the whole French society is mobilizing against this unfair and sexist reform. The vast majority of the French population rejects this reform for the following reasons. Firstly, the legal retirement age will be pushed back from 62 to 64 with a lengthening of the contribution period. Secondly, this reform will reinforce inequalities by systematically penalizing those with the most precarious careers, women, people of color, undocumented workers, people with disabilities, LGBTQ, and so on, that often do not enjoy the privilege of having one continuous career and steady contributions. The way the pensions are calculated today systematically penalizes them, and this reform will make it worse. Also, the forceful adoption of the reform occults any reflection on the increased difficulty of work due to ever-increasing productivity requirements and will oblige people already in disastrous conditions, such as nurses, teachers, maintenance workers and many others, to keep working in conditions harmful for their health. By the age of 64, it is 28 of the poorest workers that are dead already, against 6% of the wealthiest. We want people to be able to assert their rights before they die. Finally, as only 55% of people aged between 55 and 64 are active in France, almost half of this age group will remain longer in precarious situations, particularly unemployment. It is important to say that the parliamentary oppositions try to debate the modalities of the reform, for example by proposing to increase the employers and employee contributions, but these debates were continuously cut short by the presidential party. Finally, his use of Monday of Article 49.3 of the Constitution, allowing him to bypass parliamentary support, confirmed Macron's party contempt for French democracy. Considering the government's continued disregard of parliamentary debate, in view of its determination to implement this reform rejected by 80% of the population, because today in France we can no longer rely on institutional tools to support the will of the people, our only possibility is then to continue the street mobilization and the strikes to support our determination to refuse this unfair and sexist reform of pension system. The resistance has been massive and everywhere for a fair and inclusive pension system. Thank you for your presence and support today.